Hey guys, what's going on? This is Qazi. In this episode, we're going to talk about curves. Unfortunately, not the kind you're thinking about. I just want to take a second to thank each and every one of you. We just hit over 100 subscribers in less than 6 days, and we have 6,737 views 6 days in. Okay, so this is our previous grid that we did using primaries. Most of the magic happened in the second node. Let's go ahead and create a new version. And I'm gonna reset everything. I'm gonna create 3 nodes. I do all my primaries, or in this case, we're gonna be using curves, but I do that in my second node. First node is reserved for noise reduction. Third depends on what your image is and what it needs, but in this one we're just going to be creating a window in this one. So here's the thing, there's different ways that you can use curves. You know, you can just start off doing something like that and then just create like a gentle S or whatever kind of look you're going for. Again, always remember, talk to your client, ask them what they're looking for, ask for some samples. Samples are huge, huge help, because you can bring it into Resolve, you can pop it in your gallery, and then you can see if you're getting close. In this case, I'm just gonna stick with a little bit moody and test the dynamic range of this camera. I'm gonna show you first just using regular curves, and then I'm gonna show you my preferred method, okay? So let's just see. Okay, like we can bring this down a little bit, like keep it somewhere around here. Then my highlights, we can pop the highlights a little bit and bring the midtones. This is looking pretty good. That's looking pretty good, and I like what it's doing in this area right here. If you remember in the last episode, we were dealing with some noise issues, so it seems like with curves, it's a little bit more gentle with that, and I'm liking what's happening with my highlights too, so we can leave that there. Then we can add saturation, crank it all the way, just go all the way, and then look at it, and finally we're seeing some separation, and we're seeing our colors now pop in. We're seeing our blues, our reds, and then now that we're seeing our colors, let's start pulling it back and leave it where we think it looks the best. So in this case, I would say somewhere around here. Also, always remember, if it's going on the web when you export, and if you see your ProRes versus H.264, H.265, there's always gonna be a tiny bit watered down effect where it will just pull the saturation a little bit and it'll low con it a little bit. It's not gonna do it too much. So sometimes I will just overcompensate right here, but also look at my scope and just make sure that everything is good and everything is kosher. So everything is looking fine. I mean, we're under where we're supposed to be, so everything is good. Let's make this bigger. So that's one approach for curves, okay? Now I'm gonna create another version. Right here, I'm gonna get rid of that, and now I'm gonna show you my preferred method. And what you need to do here is go click on these 3 dots, and you gotta turn on editable splines. Let's look at it in action. So just watch how the toe is responding when I'm moving the shoulder, and vice versa. Unlike the default curve, here we have everything moving in unison, which gives us better roll-offs on both highs and lows. It's just a much more efficient, assisted process that speeds up your workflow. Okay, so let's just say this is looking good. Let's go back to our saturation, add that saturation in where we want it. Something like that. And now let's look at the curve we created without the editable spline. It was looking good until we did the editable splines. And now you can just see how gentle the roll off is in the highlights and in the shadows. Okay, moving on. Now I'm gonna go ahead and copy my noise reduction and windows from the previous episode to get consistent results when comparing different methods. I'm gonna go ahead and delete the default version and use the editable splines version to compare with the primaries. So now we have primaries on the left and we have curves on the right. If you ask me personally, I would go with primaries. And that's just my preference, because if you look at the highlights, I mean, this just looks so much natural. I don't always prefer using the primaries. 90% of the time, I'm just using LUTs as a starting point and then going from there. But there are shows I work on where I don't get a list of all the cameras that were used per shot. So then I just get a one baked file. I have to scene cut it in Resolve and I have to figure it out. And a lot of the times in that case, I am relying on primaries because I cannot just cross my fingers, drop a LUT and just hope that it works. In the next episode, we will grade the same footage using contrast and pivot, and at the end of that episode, we will do a comparison, seeing the difference between primaries, curves, and contrast and pivot. And none of the stuff that I'm doing is scientific. I am building these grades in front of you so you can see my approach, my thought process, see inside my head what I'm thinking when I'm doing that. All right, guys, that wraps up today's video. Thank you so much for sticking around and watching this episode. Please let me know what's your preferred method and do you ever switch your methods depending on the job you're on. I will see you in the next one.